see Mr. Wagner, please.
Mr. Wagner's busy.
Do you need a good piano player here?
No piano player.
We want to use Come On Mama in our act.
That's Jim Carrey.
I want to have an orchestration made.
See Harry Raymond.
I have an appointment with Mr. Wagner.
Can't see, he's busy.
But I've got an appointment.
And you've got an awful crust, too. That don't get you by me. Sit down. And what do you want?
I'd like to see someone who's published my song.
Ha ha, so would I.
How about Mr. Wagner?
Say, didn't you hear me say Mr. Wagner was busy?
Of course, all of Manhattan heard you. What of it?
Hey, are you trying to make a clown out of me?
Certainly not. Your parents did that.
No way!
That's just what I'm going to do.
Music.
Me? Ha! I was brung up on it.
Well, so long.
Hey, don't you want a number?
No. This is the way I kill an afternoon.
How?
Giving you song pluggers a ride.
So long.
Say, wait a minute. Aren't you a singer?
Me a singer? Ha! No, I'm a subway guard.
Well, I'm
worried a muzzler. Get yourself a fork full of that.
Raymond and Tierney, the reports on your act are so bad I can't possibly get any bookings. I suggest you frame something new, then perhaps I can sell it. Sincerely yours, Max Hayes, agent.
That listens like we better hang on to this job.
What for? We don't need this job. Or Wagner either.
Oh, you're starting again, huh? Every time we get set, you start something.
How many times have I told you to be big? Not too big, but big. You're just as big as you think you are.
And in the meantime, who pays Mr. Child for the sausage and waffle?
Leave that to me.
Yeah, I left it to you. And now look, ixnay the pansy, the...
Remember my mammy was old.
This is the number we're going after, boys. Plug it for all it's worth.
Oh, Mr. Wagner, have you heard the last song I wrote?
I hope so.
But really, Mr. Wagner, if you hear it, I know you'll grab it.
Behave yourself. You're a song plugger, not a songwriter. Now go after this hot and heavy. We've got to put it over big.
But, Mr. Wagner, if you heard my song...
I heard it.
But you haven't heard it since I changed the tempo. I tell you, it's a different song. It's wonderful.
Well, I haven't got time.
It's marvelous. Now that I've got you here, you've got to listen to it. It's only fair to me. Why, this is the greatest thing I ever did, and that's saying plenty. Why, when I wrote this song, I said to myself, Harry, boy, you wrote a humdinger. And I'm proud of you, because you put all your personality right in it. Now that I've got your undivided attention, please listen, and above all, don't interrupt me. You notice that flourish with the...
Well, what's the...
Oh, I... that is, I... How do you do?
Is that one of Mr. Wagner's songs?
I should say not. That's my own.
Oh, you write too.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I've just written a song, and I was wondering... That is, I was hoping... I mean, do you think you could possibly help me to place it?
Why, Mr. Wagner leaves all those things to me.
Oh.
Is this the song?
Yes.
Let's see. I'll just play the chorus. Did you write this song? Why, they stopped writing this kind of song about 20 years ago. Now, when I write a song, I... Oh, why, I'm sorry. I didn't know it meant so much to you.
It's sort of the last straw.
That is all, then?
Worse. My partner, Goldie DeVere, and I have been playing Grosville. You may have heard of them, Fenton and DeVere.
Fenton and DeVere. Oh, yes.
We were going along fine until movie sort of ruined Roseville. And then with no bookings and everything going out and nothing coming in, it's been rather hard. So I thought perhaps I could sell my song.
Wait a minute. You know, on second thought, I think the song has possibilities.
Do you really?
Well, let's look at it again. Now, the verse has a nice swing to it. But the chorus isn't there. Now, take my chorus. Wait a minute. Can you play the piano?
Yes, a little.
Great. I'll tell you what you do. You play your verse and my chorus, and a strange coincidence, the words fit beautifully. You play it, and I'll sing it, and you tell me what you think of it. I've got a grand idea. I'll be right back. Say, will you do me a favor?
Glad to. What is it?
Will you please play a verse of this and two choruses of that? It's only a lead sheet. Ask the boys to take it for her. Thank you ever so much.
You're welcome. They're going to play it for us.
Oh, that's fine.
I could turn a failure to success if you always were near. I could make my dreams come true, but it will depend on you. With you a sunny day, without you a thousand stars. With you my luck will stay. Without you, fortune will fly. With you, I'll never come until I've reached the top. Without you, I will never get on. With you, a happy song. Without you, castle that falls. With you, I can't go wrong. Without you, chances are small. With you, my banners unfurled, right there on top of the world. Without you, I'm just nothing at all.
Why, it's marvelous. Say, Wagger will kiss me for this one. Wait till I tell him about it.
With you, my banners unfurled, right there on top of the world. Without you, I'm just nothing.
I'll be right back.
Hey!
Oh,
Now, what I'd like
boy,
to do...
Boy, I've got it. The hit of the year.
See here, what do you mean
it's
by...
It's dynamite. It can't miss.
What do you mean by
it's
coming...
It's got everything a song should have and more.
Would you shut up and get
anything
out of here?
Anything you want it to be, it is. It's surefire. Do you get me? It's surefire. Do you know what surefire is?
I sure do, and you're it.
What?
Surefire.
Why? Why, you can't fire me. I just got a week's salary in advance.
That's cheap at half the price. Now get out.
If he goes, I go.
Much obliged.
Don't mention it. You can't talk to my pal that way.
Come on, Harry.
So you finally went and done it.
How many times have I got to tell you never to say you went and done it?
Never mind my grammar. Look what a spot you put us on.
Us? You didn't have to quit. Just because I got the air.
Oh, no? What would you do without me? You've got to have somebody to listen to your stuff. Besides, I don't like the job. I should maybe have ought to have quit anyway.
Miss Benton, meet my partner, Jimmy Tierney.
Pleased to meet you.
How do you do? Mr. Raymond, I hope I haven't caused you any trouble.
Trouble? Oh, the song. I know. The song went over great. Didn't it, Jimmy?
Sure, a panic.
Sure, they wanted it. But they suggested some changes.
Two changes.
He means in the song. Yeah. If we could find a place where they had a piano, some place where we could work on it.
Well, we have a piano at our flat.
That's enough. That's enough. Lady, if you have the piano, all you need is us.
Say, I thought I gave you guys the air.
The pansy.
Excuse me. You did, but get this. You'll be crawling on your hands and knees begging me for a song. But you'll have to see my secretary first.
Mr. Wagner.
Yes?
Meet the secretary. Home, James.
And I'll travel along, singing a vagabond song. the flower, the bird song at dawning. Just let me see that sunrise each morning, and I'll travel along singing a vagabond song. Happy you may be with all your passions, your passion, and all the great thoughts that you might say. You couldn't train with me, your foolery and your jewelry. Look at me, I'm king of all I purvey. Come on and give me the stars. God, heaven above me, worry at that time, that one who will love me, and I'll travel along, singing a vagabond song.
Glad you like that, folks. But before I get through, you'll probably want me to sing all night for you.
I suppose you think you're good, you big fat head.
I resent that remark.
Oh, you're kidding.
Say, listen, when you cold heavers get through clowning around, I'll continue with my act.
Yeah, that's what we're afraid of.
Now, wait a minute, you fellas.
Hey, can you do any magic?
Yes, I can do that.
Well, make yourself disappear.
Don't bother with him.
Get that muzzler off and let's see the picture.
Say, any of you faux hunks want to fight, just step up here.
You keep out of it.
What are you trying to do?
I didn't do it. You're making him the goat. Why don't you educate your audiences to be ladies and gentlemen? They started it. He never did.
He started now. He's kidding.
Well, if he goes, we go.
You're gone already. And another thing. I'm going to report this affair, and if you don't get a wire canceling the rest of your time, I'm crazy. Bring on that other act.
I didn't. Well, you know this fellow's...
This is what I call the end of a perfect day.
And it was all my fault, too. Wasn't it? Well, wasn't it?
Well, what do you expect me to do, kiss you?
No, I don't expect you to kiss me.
Yes. Manager didn't waste any time.
Well, your boyfriend fixed us good and plenty this time.
Poor Goldie, it wasn't his fault.
Oh, don't tell me.
He's all right. He made a little mistake, that's all.
Mistake my eye. Quit apologizing for him and tell him the truth about himself. I wouldn't like it, but it might do him a lot of good.
Let's go over and read it to the gals and all four of us take it on the chin together.
Wait a minute. I'll take it on the chin. It's coming to me. It was my fault anyhow.
Now, listen. They'd rather.
Maybe you're right.
Come in.
Well? Here's the payoff.
See, that manager's sure a fast worker.
Isn't it so?
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Raymond and Tierney, Mansion House, Anthracite, Illinois. Scout for George Barnes caught act on road. Want you to report immediately New York for Broadway review.
Baby! Oh,
wait a minute, wait a minute, there's more. Have booked Goldie and Tierney as teams to open Salt Lake, Chicago week after. Dolores and you report New York immediately. Congratulations, Max Hayes, agent. The nerve of that guy. Sending for only half of the act.
No, well, of course we can't accept it.
Certainly not.
What do you mean you can't accept it? If you don't, you're nuts.
Well, it isn't fair. There are four of us, and either they take all four or they don't get any.
No way. Look, you and Dolores, go ahead. Get yourself sitting pretty on Broadway. Me and Goldie, well, we'll plug along somehow. Can't tell. We'll have to make the grade sometime ourselves. Uncle Lee.
Sure. Why, Jimmy and me'll have an act of our own, and by the time we hit New York, why, the managers will be fighting for us.
Are you two on a level about this?
Sure. Well, we were cinch. What do you say, baby? How's for a cup of jam?
You said it.
Wait a minute. Will you two swear that you don't think we're walking out on you?
Oh, lay off. Well, yeah. Listen. Ain't we pals?
Look, that means a wedding.
You better look out, Jim.
Better look out yourself.
Well, honey, aren't you happy? Why, what's the trouble? What's wrong?
Oh, it's nothing. Nothing at all.
Oh, come on. Tell me. What is it?
Harry, I'm afraid there's one thing that's going to keep you from being a big success.
What?
It's that thing that caused our trouble at the theater tonight. That me stuff that makes everyone think you're conceited.
Now, listen, I don't...
I'm telling you this because Well, I like you. And not to hit your feelings. But Harry at the theater tonight, after you finished singing the song, you unconsciously kept saying to the audience, "Boy, I'm good." And you know how they resented it.
Gee. I never looked at it that way before. I guess you're right. The first time anybody ever put me wise to myself. And I think you're wonderful to tell me.
Harry, please.
Oh, no, I love you too much ever to let you get away from me.
Harry.
If I ever accomplish anything in this world, it'll be because of you, Dolores. You know, I was thinking if I tried awfully hard to be the fella you wanted me to be, well, I thought maybe you'd marry me. You would? We're engaged.
Yes, dear.
Gosh, we ought to have an engagement ring. Pardon me. Now, everything is according to Hoyle.
Happiness with you close to me, dear. I could turn a failure to success if you always were near. I could make my dreams come true, but it will depend on you.
A very good number.
Yes. Who is the man?
Oh, the man. Raymond. Harry Raymond.
Oh, he's splendid, isn't he? Oh, what's next?
Putting on the wrist.
With her mouth full, rubbing elbows.
Chicago, where Harlem sits. Putting on the wrist. Ankle counts upon the belly of high ground. Turn down the levee, all misfits. And how they're putting on the wrist. That's where each and every Lulu's bell goes. Every Thursday evening with her swell bow. Robbie Elbow, come with me and we'll attend their jubilee and see them spend their last 2 bits. And how they're putting on the wrist.
From now on, if you want to.
How about a little rain?
Yeah, and half of the show, I suppose.
Not a bad idea either.
You could kind of go for him, wouldn't you, Ted?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe.
Well, knowing you as I do, I say, it won't be long now.
Entitled When It's Poking a Time in Hawaii, I hope they fall on you.
Cherry, cherry, within your eyes I see that light of love that I've been always dreaming of. Cherry, although I know it cannot be, I give up all. The call of love. There's danger in your eyes, Jenny, but I don't care. I give up paradise, Jenny. You're not allowed to care. Your kisses taste like wine. And when your lips I know that any sin with you would be divine. There's danger in your charm, Jenny, that all of this to linger in your arms, Jenny, and just kiss and kiss. Just tell me when I.
you in the hands of our celebrated 46-piece orchestra. 30 of the boys didn't show up, but the other 16 will be very glad to play for you. And for the benefit of the out-of-town buyers, they're going to play for their first selection that beautiful number entitled There Comes a Time in Every Woman's Life When a Man Needs $50. Back go down on the belly of high round, down the belly of his head, holding on a bit. That's where we can every loose down cold. Every Thursday evening with her spell of cold. Now they almost come with me and will pretend their views on me and me to spend their last 2 bits. Holding on a bit.
Wonderful tonight,
dear. Oh, she always tells me I'm wonderful.
Well, I won't tell you you're wonderful, because I have an entirely different opinion of you, and you won't like it.
Why, what do you mean?
I mean you've got to slow down, Harry. Working in a show, running a nightclub, staying up all night, you can't last. It isn't in the cards.
Now listen, George, if you came here to tell me...
And you're hitting the booze, too. It's beginning to show in your voice.
Now, you're both acting like children and forgetting that you're friends.
No, Dolores. Harry is the one that's forgetting all about his good friends. And if you ask me, he hasn't even been giving you a square deal lately.
What are you talking about, a square deal?
I'll tell you what I'm talking about. You're letting a society dame make a chump out of you. And you're neglecting Dolores in order to play around with a bunch of shallow wasters that aren't even fit to breathe the same air that she breathes.
Oh, George, you're forgetting that Harry has to cater these people. It's part of his business, and he's not neglecting his old friends or me.
Now, you see, George, you're wrong. I don't mean to neglect Dolores or any of my pals. Why, I see her all the time. She's coming to a party I'm giving at my house Christmas Eve. She's going to be... You are going to be my guest of honor, aren't you, darling?
Well, I may be wrong. If I am, I'm sorry.
Of course you are. Are you ready to leave with George and me, dear?
Why, well, you see, it's like this, dear.
Hey, come along, dear. We're waiting for you.
I'll be right with you. Excuse me, darling. I'll phone you the first thing in the morning and explain everything. George, will you take care of Dolores for me? Good night.
Oh, are you ready, dear?
All ready.
Party. Are you really enjoying yourself?
Am I? Ask Fenway. I was just telling him what a perfect host you are.
That's right. I have never seen Teddy quite so enthused over anything or anyone before.
That's fine.
Gee, isn't it a grand party?
Oh, wonderful.
Doctor, are you enjoying yourself?
Harry, it's a perfect party.
I'm awfully glad.
Well, honey, didn't I tell you the truth? Right out of the blue book. All of them. No kidding. We're in society.
I'm afraid we are. My honey, you aren't kidding.
Oh, yes. Dolores will take care of everything for you.
Yes, I'll have places fixed for you at the table.
Oh, honey. Gee, I'm sorry I didn't get your telegram. I would have invited an entirely different bunch. Well, you may not like these people. They're sort of snobby.
Oh, we don't mind. If we can stand them acrobats and them train sales, we can stand anybody.
Well, here we are. Now make yourselves right at home.
Oh, say, you sure we're not hauling in?
Oh, don't be foolish. Just ring for anything that you want. I'll see you later.
Great guy, Harry.
You said it. We used to have an act together, Doctor. We were on the road for a long time.
Really?
Where are Goldie and Jim?
Why, they're having dinner in the guest room.
Guest room? Oh, Harry, I must tell you something very funny. Last night as we were driving home, it was a little...
Funny, Jimmy, but... Gee, I ain't hungry.
Neither am I.
Are you having a good time?
I'm having a fun.
Including everybody else in the party, including Harry. Now what a time I am having.
Well, how do you do?
Come home to your daddy.
Harry said to sing you the prettiest song you've ever heard.
Ready for our side.
And one that he built all by his little self. Didn't you, my darling?
Now, wait a minute. I said
I'll come along now.
She wants a little song from Harry. A little song.
Are you going to sing the song all for me?
I'm going to sing it all for you and nobody but you. Because every time when I sing a song,
you be serious and pull yourself together. I want you to sing this as only my Harry can sing it.
You said,
with you a sunny day, without you love in the sky. With you my luck will change, without you fortune will fly.
Did you ring, madam?
You heard the bell, didn't you?
Yes, madam, but I...
Never mind your alibis. There are some packages out there in the hall. Get them.
Oh, golly, don't be so nickel and dime.
Say, if you think I'm going to leave a lot of good presents for that high-hatted heel, you're all off your nut. And I take it you're not off your nut, are you?
No, madam.
Get them.
Yes, madam.
I'm a good man?
Yes. Watching you make a fool and me.
Yes.
Why don't you marry him and be done with it?
Silly boy. As if anyone could take your place. He doesn't use it, that's all. I get the same kind of kick out of him as I get out of a cloud. But if it's going to worry you, dear, I might manage to drop him. He means nothing to me. Let's drink a toast.
All right. I have a good one for you.
The toast.
To your clown.
Oh, my dear, won't you join us? Thank you. I think Harry should join us in your toast, Mrs. Van Rensselaer. Harry.
I'm being paid. Well, here we are.
Mr. Brooks and Mrs. Van Rensselaer were about to offer a toast, which I insist on your hearing. Of course, you won't mind repeating it, Mr. Brooks, will you?
Well, I...
Come on, Brooks, tell us.
I'll repeat the toast. To our charming host, the one and only Harry Raymond. The clown.
The clown? Why, what are you talking about, Dolores?
Ask your dear friend. Ask her who amuses her. Who's her clown? If she'll tell the truth, she'll say you are, because I heard her say it a minute ago.
That's not true.
Dolores, I'm ashamed of you.
Yes, and I'm ashamed of you. You're carried away by the praise and applause of these so-called friends, while behind your back they're laughing at you and ridiculing you. But you're too stupid to realize it.
Now listen,
you turn down your real friends. Well, they want nothing more to do with you. And I thought you developed into a real man. But instead you've become a vain, impossible fool. A blind fool, oh. And a born a sea otter.
Blind fool, eh? I'll show you.
So let's not lose our sense of humor.
She can't talk that way to me.
Well, come along and sing a song.
I don't want to sing it.
Oh, do I?
I don't want to sing a song.
I'll play the background song and you sing it.
Well, you can play it, but I don't want
to. But everybody
sing.
Wants to hear you.
Well, all right, I'll...
I'm a wanderer through life's highway, facing the world with a song and a smile.
I'm tickled to death you did it. No wonder you didn't hit him over the head with a bottle. That's what I'd have done.
Listen, honey. No matter what he said or done to you, you never should have left him with them brooches. He ate himself.
Oh, pipe down.
Now listen, will you take the lorries over to the apartment. I'm going to stick around here for a while in case Harry needs me.
Well, help yourself, big shot. But listen. I'm telling you something. That guy's so big he needs an 18-day diet for his head.
Come on. Your jewelry and your jewelry. Look at me, I'm king of all I obey. So give me the stars that heaven above me. Just let me know that thou who will love me.
Finish the song, Harry.
No, I don't want to sing.
Oh, please sing for me.
No, let somebody else sing. I don't want to sing.
Oh, won't you sing a little up close?
Maybe after a while. I don't want to sing.
What's happened? Is anything wrong?
Hey, you, get a doctor.
Dr. Blair, is he in?
Get him, quick.
Yes, sir.
And keep everybody else out of here.
Yes, sir.
It's all right, Harry. Don't worry. I'll take care of you.
Yes, the doctor, sir.
What's wrong, Harry?
Something wrong with his eyes, Doc.
Where'd this flask come from, Harry?
I don't know. Somebody gave it to me tonight.
Did you drink any of it?
Sure. A lot of it.
Bad whiskey. I'm afraid we'll have to take him to the hospital.
Why? What for?
I'm awfully sorry to have to tell you this, Harry. But you're in bad shape. Very bad.
You mean I'm going to be blind?
Look, Doc, it ain't going to be permanent, is it?
Well, I...
What did he say, Jimmy? What did he say?
It's all right, Harry. Don't worry. Jimmy's going to stick right with him.
Come on, Harry.
Come on. Be up, pal. That's the boy.
She was right, Jimmy. I am a fool. Just a blind fool.
Give me the flowers, the birds song at dawning. Just let me know that sunrise each morning, and I'll travel along singing a vagabond song. Happy you may be with your passion, and all the great parts that you play. Ah, you couldn't trade with me your foolery and your jewelry. Look at me, I'm king of all I survey. Come on and give me the stars. God, heaven above me, where is that pal, that one who will love me? And I'll travel along, taking a vagabond
How are you, old boy? What a song and what a voice. You're better than ever.
Ah, Jimmy, you always got something nice to say.
Listen, I got some grand news for you. I met Doc Blair on the street today, and he tells me you've got every chance in the world.
That's fine, isn't it? How's Dolores?
Oh, better than ever. And everything looks great for her in the new show. Barnes says she's a cinch to knock him over. You know, they open tomorrow night.
Gee, that's great, isn't it?
There's just one thing wrong, Harry.
Why?
She's terribly worried about you. Why don't you let me tell her? You know about your eyes.
No, Jimmy. We've been all over that. I don't want anybody to know. Least of all, Dolores. I was too good for her when I was a success. Well, she's too good for me now. And what's more, I know it.
Ah, forget it.
Disappear through the looking glass. You'll
kitty liked you well when you read of the girl who was sitting by the fire with her kitten in the story that was written long ago. Come along with us into Wonderland, to the lovely palace where they're all so grand. See the funny people strolling hand in hand. Come along and pass through the looking glass into Wonderland. Come take a peek at the queer looking duchess with the rabbit in her clutches, which is just about as much as he can stand. There's Tweedledum, Tweedledee, hear them prattle all about a broken rattle. Tweedledee has got a battle on his hand. Look here, you can see the walrus, and there's a carpenter by his side. Look there, how the little oyster and Humpty Dumpty who fall down from the wall. That isn't all. You'll be delighted with the high-handed man called the Mad Little Hatter. Never mind about his chatter, cause it really doesn't matter, but it's grand. Come along with us into Wonderland, to the lovely palace where they're all so grand. See the funny people floating hand in hand. Come along and pass through the looking glass into Wonderland.
You can do it.
Oh, I can't, George. You know I never sing that song without Harry.
What are you talking about? Of course you can. Go on,
George. Come on, honey. You can sing.
Play with me.
Oh, no, George. Yes.
Thank you.
Looking marvelous. You've never been as beautiful as you are tonight. Darling, don't feel sorry for me.
Oh, my poor
boy. Why, honey, there's nothing the matter with me. It seems like I can see you now for the first time.